Another Prada bag that I have. Whoa. Oh my God. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name's Ivory. And for today's video, I'm going to be doing my handbag collection for 2020. Also guys, for this bag collection, I'm only going to be featuring my designer bags, which includes the ones behind me. I'm not going to be doing like the mainstream or the street brands like Michael Kors and Coach and Kate Spade, just the ones that are behind me. So the first item I'm going to be showing you is actually a backpack, and it is from Fendi. It is a vintage backpack. It's made out of canvas and leather. I love the contrasting colors with the black, and it also has gold hardware. It has a top handle, which is great. And on the back, this is what it looks like. And on the bottom, it has 4 feet. The strap is inside, so you open it by pushing this together, and it opens up. It is a drawstring backpack. Here's the straps to make it a backpack. And it's basically just one hole. And there's a pocket in the back right here, if I could show you. Right here, with the Fendi emblem. And yes, I believe there's only one pocket. Yep, it's only one pocket. This bag is great because it's big enough to use as a everyday backpack. Also, big enough to use as a travel backpack if you don't carry a lot of things. The first time I saw this backpack was actually from a YouTuber. Her name is June and her channel is Hey June. And I searched and searched for this backpack, and it is so rare and it's so hard to find that I just gave up. And then one day I saw it on Mercari and I got it at such a great price. And a lot of people have been messaging me on Instagram asking me if they can buy it off of me. But I think it's one of those pieces that I really treasure and I'm going to keep in my collection for a long time. Also, I forgot to mention that you could actually use this as a crossbody. It has these two circles right here where you attach it, and you can use it as a crossbody. And then it has a little front pocket right here. Just open up. And you can put like some cards, some coins in there. It's big enough that you can actually fit small items in here. Continuing with Fendi, I have my mini peekaboo right here. I love this bag, but I treat it like a baby because of the leather. I believe it's Napa leather, and it's so buttery soft, but it's prone to get scratches easily. So I take good care of her. It has two compartments right here, and it can hold a lot of things for a mini bag. Here's the strap. And the thing about this is it has its own raincoat. Let me go ahead and pop it on for you so you can see. This is what it looks like with its raincoat. I think it's so adorable. It even has the outline of the peekaboo, and it goes all the way around. It's great when you want to protect your handbag. You can even tuck in the strap if you want. So it's great if, you know, if it rains or it snows. I really treat this baby, this bag as a baby. And I got it in this beautiful plum color with gold hardware. Going back to vintage, I have this small chef bag. I believe it's called mini chef bag, and they call it that because it looks like a little chef's hat. So it's in this monogram print. It has a little tag here that says Fendi, and it actually fits a lot of things for it being so mini because of the bottom. It kind of flows out, and I usually wear this as a crossbody. I bought a different strap so I could use it as a crossbody. My last Fendi bag is this one right here. This is called the Mama Baguette. And it is in this beautiful ivory and beige color with silver hardware. I actually bought a separate strap. It's kind of like a reoccurring theme that I like to wear my mini bags as a crossbody. So I bought an extra strap. It is actually Fendi. And I use it as a crossbody now. This bag is small, but it can hold so many things, including my iPhone 11 Pro Max, just because on the bottom is a lot more wider. It's sort of like this triangle shape, but yeah, it holds a lot of things for such a mini bag. I have two bags from Burberry. The first one is this Boston bag right here with the beautiful checkered print that they're known for. It's patent leather in some areas and gunmetal hardware. Here's what it looks like from the side. And this one is a great travel bag as well. It stores a lot of things. I haven't actually used this in a while, but when you open it up, there's plenty of room and you get one zipper compartment in the back. The other Burberry bag I have, I featured in another video, which is this Burberry pouch. Here's the strap that it didn't come with it. I bought it separately, but it is a bucket bag. And this is their new print. I believe it's called the Icon print. And it just says Burberry, London, England on the bottom. And this one holds a lot as well. It's just one big compartment on the inside. The next two brands I'm gonna be showing you, I have one bag from each designer house. The first one is this Balenciaga mini city bag. It has giant silver hardware. I love this bag. This one is so well used because I use it a lot for spring and summer. I love the color, and it comes with a strap. And there's just one zipper compartment in the back. I believe that's all, yes. And it's such a great shape. I love rectangular bags like this. And I'm not sure what the leather is, but it's really hard wearing, and it's really maintained its shape, as well as there's not a lot of scratches on it, so it is a hard wearing bag. I'm not very gentle when it comes to wearing this one, but yeah, it's a really cute pinkish purpley bag. This one is my Dior mini Lady Dior bag. I believe that's the name, I'm not sure, but I love that it has this cute little charm on the front. It says Dior. And the great thing about this one is it has this translucent handle. It's so cute. I love the color as well. This one is really mini that you can't really fit a lot in it, but I just think it's really cute. The way you open it, it's just a little flap, and it does come with the strap, but it's a little short. It's more of a shoulder bag, but that's what the inside looks like. I just have it stuffed at the moment. There is a zipper compartment right here in the back, and it's just a cute little bag for a spring. Another pink bag in my collection is this Prada one. This is probably one of the smallest bags that I have in my collection. I love this bow detail. It has gold hardware as well, and you could use this actually as a clutch. The strap is removable, and then you would place your fingers through here while you're holding it. So it shows off the bow detail. I think it's so cute. This one actually does fit my iPhone 11 Pro Max. The material is nylon, so it's a little bit stretchy. And here's the strap. And then on the inside, it has two compartments, one in the back and one in the front. And it has the print for Prada. It just says Prada all over. And I love it. It's such a cute little mini bag in this fun color. Another product bag that I have in my collection, I just featured in another video, but it is this one, my newest bag, and the bag I'm currently using. It is the Prada Nylon re-edition bag in black with silver hardware. I really love this bag. This is such a great everyday bag. It's so casual, so comfy to wear, and it comes with so many little items. Like this little pouch, the clochette. There's another silver strap that I have in the box that I don't use, and the thick strap. So this one's a great handbag. My last Prada bag is also a nylon bag, and it's this bucket bag right here. This one, I don't baby it at all. It's one of my used bags in my collection. I love the navy color. It has gold hardware. It has a big pocket in the front, and on the inside it's just one hole and there's no pockets on the inside. And this one I used so much just because I could fit so many things. It has a crossbody strap right here. And you can just not baby it. It's hard wearing just because of the nylon. And it could stand like the rain, snow. It's such a great bag. I would highly recommend this one. Next are my Miu Miu bags. And Miu Miu is a sister company of Prada. So I also featured these two bags in some of my recent videos. But here's the first one in this beautiful tartan print or plaid print. It has Miu Miu in the front and silver hardware. And the print goes all the way in the back and also on the inside. The straps are detachable, so you can actually use this as a clutch if you like. It's made out of wool, and there's no pockets on the inside. The other Miu Miu bag I have, I just featured in the last video. This one is the nude mini backpack, silver hardware, and it is a shoulder slash crossbody bag. The strap is on the inside. It has this silver strap. And it's just so tiny and mini. It has a little pocket on the front. And you can fit a few cards in there, some coins, chapstick. It's just so tiny and cute. I have one item from Dolce & Gabbana, but it's more of a clutch, not really a bag. But it is this fun polka dot clutch. It's made out of satin, and it reminded me of a birthday dress that I had when I was younger. It was black and it had like these fun colors, just like this one. But I believe it was flowers instead of polka dots. But nonetheless, it really reminded me of that dress. That's why I purchased it. And on the front, it just has D&G in silver. And it has two magnetic buttons. And that's how you open it. There's a compartment here. And then a zipper compartment right here in the front. And it has the D&G logo there. This one also comes with a strap. It's meant for a shoulder strap, but I can actually wear this as a crossbody. So you can either wear it that way or just tuck in the strap and wear it as a clutch. I also only have one bag from this designer house, and it is from YSL. I love this bag. I believe it's called the Mini Vicky. There's two versions of this. One that is just plain padded like this without the pocket, and it just has the emblem. But this one actually has a pocket in the front, which I like. You can fit maybe cards in here, some coins, and it actually zips all the way down, all the way across. But it has these leather pieces on the sides, so none of your items fall out. And yes, this one has a back pocket as well. And here's the logo, Saint Laurent. And here's the strap. It's not detachable, but it is adjustable. So it's such a cute bag. I love this one as well. I wear this on a fancier date night or fancier occasions, just because I think it looks a little bit more elevated and not as casual. I have two Gucci bags that are sort of similar. This is one of them. This is the Mini Marmont gold hardware in black. Has the big GG in the back, two tassels, and this is what the strap looks like. Oops, right here. On the inside, it just has one compartment. The material is sort of like suede on the inside, and it is in a light beige, so it could get a little dirty if you don't take care of it. But I wore this bag a lot as well. It's a great mini bag. It does have a little bit stretch to it, but it's the perfect little mini size bag for me. That's why I gravitate towards this a lot, and black actually matches with a lot of things, so I use this bag a lot. My other Gucci bag is this patent leather one. This is the Gucci Soho Disco bag, and this size is actually really great as well. I love these camera style bags. It has this cute little tassel with gold hardware. This is what the strap looks like. It's not connected right now. Let me show you the inside. This one has a linen interior with one pocket in the front. One pocket in the back and one pocket in the front. And I also got the matching wallet as well. This one comes in the regular leather, but I think that one tends to slouch a little bit more. So the patent leather one actually holds the structure a bit more, but over time it's still gonna like sag a little bit. But as long as you keep it stuffed or have the insert, then it should keep its shape. Also, with patent leather bags, I usually don't wear them during the summer because it can get sticky and it might rub against something, so then it might cause color transfer. So I like to use this in the spring and not so much in the summer when it gets really, really hot. My one and only Celine bag is this one. This is the Celine Nano luggage bag. I believe that's the name. I wanted this bag for a very long time. A lot of people rave about this bag. I can see why, because since it's a mini bag, it's big enough that it actually holds so much items. Here's the strap that it comes with. There is one zipper compartment right here. I'm sorry, it's not a zipper. It is just an open compartment in the back. And it's just a big hole that you could just dump everything in. This is a great travel bag. There's a zipper in the front, but you can probably only fit like maybe coins or a chapstick or a mint or something inside there. But this is great bag because it has two handles. And also this bag is known for having this little pocket right here where you can slip your sunglasses into. But yeah, it's a great bag. I'm not sure what kind of leather this is, but it's soft leather that it does scratch a bit. So I have to be very careful with this one. But this one I like to use as a travel bag. The next two bags I'm going to show you aren't really high-end designer bags, but they are in my collection here in the back. So I guess I'll go ahead and show it to you. But they're from MCM. This one is a vanity, mini vanity bag. It has these two clasps right here that you can attach a strap to. And the zipper's on the top. This one's very roomy as well. It's very structured, if you can hear. Here's the strap for it. And it just has a stretchy compartment in the back. And you just dump all your things in here. It's such a cute little bag as well. Has a little emblem right here. And is in the cognac color, which is what they are known for. This MCM bag is so adorable. This is what it looks like. It is actually a bunny. And it has the MCM print on his body. The eyes are Swarovski crystals, and it is meant to be a, you can use it as a crossbody, right here with the two, rings. Here's the pull tab, or you could use it as a backpack because it has rings, on the other side as well, but it opens in the back of its body and it has this strap right here. And there's pretty much a good amount of room in here. My iPhone 11 Pro Max fits in here. But it's so stinking cute. There's also a bunny, a bear version of this. And it comes in different colors. I've seen it in this color, pink. I'm not sure. It comes out in like different seasons. So the different colors in different seasons and different years. But I'm so happy I got this one, and it's a great Easter bag. I saved Louis Vuitton for last because I featured most of them in my previous videos, and half of them is actually my collection. they're mostly Louis Vuitton. The first bag I'm gonna show you was a gift from my sister. She was so nice to give me this. This is the Speedy in size 30. The Damir Ibin print. It is still in pristine condition. I really baby this one as well because it was one of my first designer bags. This is a great travel bag. This is what I used to travel with. And I love that it's in the Demerara bean print because I don't have to worry about the vachetta leather. But yes, I love this one. And I will always keep this in my collection. Next is my Louis Vuitton Never Full in the size MM. This one is very well used, as you can see in its honey color, but it is stuffed to the max right now. But what I wanted to show you was, this is the older version. So let me take out the stuffing. It has the older print, which I actually really do like. I have an organizer insert on the bottom, but this one has the old cursive writing print on the inside, and I love it. The newer ones actually have it in a different font, but I really like the cursive one on this one. So this is a well-used travel bag of mine. This one is a vintage bag. I believe it's called the Mini Cartouchier. Oh my gosh, I'm not even gonna try to say it. That's what it's called, but it's a cute little bag. It comes in an MM size and also a larger size, I believe. But this one is a vintage bag, no compartments on the inside. I do have a strap for it. I don't know where it is currently, but it has vachetta on the bottom as well. And you just lock it by pulling this through and fastening it. I like to use my monogram strap with this one as well. And this is a cute bag. I think it was meant for when you go riding. Another mini bag I have is this one. This one is called the Truce. And it's actually used for vanities, I believe. It's a vanity bag. It comes with a short strap, but I'm not sure where I placed it. But I use this long strap. It's also in the same color, the Damara Bean. But this one I got from a different Louis Vuitton bag that I sold. I just kept the strap. But this one actually holds a lot because on the bottom it's wide. And I really love the shape of it. It's sort of like a pochette, but it's taller and not as wide though. But it does hold a lot more than the pochette. Speaking of pochettes, I have two in my collection. I have the monogram and the Damer Azure. I don't have the Ebene, but I use the Truth one as my Ebene pochette bag. I use these as crossbodies, but they do come with a short strap. I believe it's in one of my Louis Vuitton boxes at the moment. But these are great too for starter pieces, as well as mini bags. If you want to use them as a crossbody bag or a shoulder bag, I'd highly recommend these. It's harder and harder to get these pieces because a lot of people want the canvas pieces. So if you can find your hands on it, I'd grab it. And yeah, this one is really old. As you can tell from the vachetta, they've darkened, but I just keep them. These are the older models, the one that doesn't have a pocket. And yeah, these are probably going to be forever pieces in my collection as well. These are not considered handbags, but I use them as handbags. And they are the mini pochettes. These are also hard to find as well. I got them in all the prints. Damara Bean, Monogram, and Damara Azure. I have the crossbody straps to go with them. I used to use them as a crossbody bag when I had a smaller iPhone, but now all the iPhones are too big, so I guess I could use them for either for my makeup or a catch-all inside bigger bags. But I'm definitely don't want to sell these because they are really hard to find, and I hope like they don't get discontinued ever, because a lot of people actually do want them. But a lot of people use them for different purposes, but I used to use them as mini bags. The next three bags I'm going to show you are my pride and joy, and they are the Eva clutch bags. There are clutches, but they're also mini bags. They have discontinued these bags. That's why they're my pride and joy. And I have him in all three of the prints, the Damier Bean. And the Damier Azure has a bigger bigger plate in the front that says Louis Vuitton. The only problem is it is beautiful, but it's also gets scratched really easily. And then I don't know, for whatever reason, the monogram one only has a small emblem. I guess because the print has LV all over it. But it does come each with a strap. Here's the strap. And then it comes with the gold chain as well on each one that hangs in the front. The only problem with that is like when you're walking around, it tends to bang on your bag, so you make a lot of noise. So most of the time I just tuck it inside. But I love, love, love this bag style. Just because it's so versatile. You can use it as a short shoulder bag, a clutch, and a crossbody bag. So these are going to stay in my collection forever as well. The next two pieces are older pieces. This one is the Mini Lin bucket bag. It comes with this adjustable strap right here. And I just bought a extra strap to make it a crossbody. That's what I like to do. I like to make my bags into crossbodies. But it is a drawstring pull bag with canvas and leather trims. This one's great because it can fit a whole bunch of things as well. It's just a bucket bag. And I believe this one also comes in a green, khaki, and a navy. But I found mine in this beautiful red. And I rarely see a lot of people use this bag, but I think it's really cute and unique. This is the other older bag I was talking about. This is the Mini Noe, the vintage version. I believe they came out with the newer version, but this one has a leather on the bottom. And it's also a drawstring. And on the inside, there's no pockets. But I also use this as a crossbody. I just attach a strap to these two rings. And it's really cute as a handheld as well. It's really mini, but it can store a lot of things inside. The thing with this bag, though, is you have to be really careful not to wear it when it rains because it will stain. This one is in pretty good condition. When I bought it, it does have a little bit of wet marks right here in the back. So you gotta be really careful. And on the top, it actually says Louis Vuitton as well. So I thought that was a cute little feature. This is the last Louis Vuitton bag and the last bag in my collection, but probably my favorite one. And that is the Mini Palm Springs backpack. I waited for this bag for the longest time, probably 6 to 8 weeks. I kept refreshing the page. I kept different times, different days. I would just keep refreshing the page to see when it would get back in stock. And finally, the week before Valentine's Day, I saw it in stock. I hurried up and grabbed it. And then I think there was probably one or two in stock because when I checked it again after I bought it, it was sold out. And it came from New York. Here's the two straps it comes with. You can wear this as a crossbody or as a backpack. I like wearing it either way. There's one pocket on the inside and then there's a mini pocket here, but I never really put anything in here because the zipper part is kind of hard to open. But this one is actually really roomy. You can fit a lot of things in here. My mini PM planners fit in here, my phone. I think you could probably maybe fit like a water bottle in here, but I love, love, love this bag. I probably won't ever get rid of it. And if it's very rare, and I think that a lot of people can also sell it for more than the asking price at Louis Vuitton because it's such a rare bag and a lot of people want their hands on this one. So this one I really love. That is it for my handbag collection. Thank you so much for staying till the end. I've definitely sold some bags and bought some new ones. So hopefully next year, some of these items are still gonna be here and hopefully I have new items as well. And thank you guys again for watching. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and I'll see you in the next video. Bye guys.